Hello everybody, and today I am going to tell you about the menstruation, and that means elementary menstruation rule 2. And today also I will tell you how to find out the area of a triangle. But if the sides are given, length of 3 sides of a triangle are given, then how to find out the area of the triangle. In my rule 1 I have told you, if base and height is given, then how to find out the area of a triangle. That means area is equal to half into base into height. Okay, so here, what is the meaning of perimeter? Perimeter means sum of the 3 sides. A plus B plus C. It is the perimeter. And by 2 means half of the perimeter. That means semi-perimeter. And it is denoted by S. Okay, so if the 3 sides are given, so how to find out the area of the triangle? Your formula is S into S minus A into S minus B into S minus A root of 4. Clear? And this is the Heron's formula. And so condition is there. First of all, you have to find out S, and S is the semi-perimeter of the triangle. That means sum of the 3 sides divided by 2, you will get S, and apply the formula. This one. So see here, I am giving an example. So you should remember the different forms. If base and height are given, then you should apply the rule 1. And if the sum of the 3 sides, if the 3 sides, length of 3 sides are given, then you can find out the area of the triangle by using this formula. Okay, so different formula you should remember. Okay, see here. If 3, 4, 5 are the 3 sides of a triangle, then what is the area of the triangle? So let us find out. Here A is equal to 3, B is equal to 4, and C is equal to 5. Anything you can take. A, B, C or A, B, C, anything. So here S is equal to A plus B plus C divided by 2. So here 3 plus 4 plus 5, 12. 12 divided by 2. 3 plus 4 it is 7, 7 plus 5 it is 12, 12 divided by 2 it is 6. Okay, so your area is equal to, what is your formula? Area is equal to S into S minus A into S minus B into S minus C square. And what is S here? S is equal to 6 into S minus A, 6 minus 3, S minus A, 6 minus 3, it is equal to 3. Okay, into S minus B, 6 minus 4, it is 2. Then S minus C, 6 minus 5, it is 1. Square root of this one. So how to find out the value? Can you find out? So 6 is equal to 6, 6 is 36, so 36 root of it is 6. 6 square roots. 3 to the 6, so 6 into 6 square root is 6 square roots. So here, you can find out very very easily actually, what is the benefit of this formula? The term will become very small. S minus A, S minus B, S minus A will become very very small terms, and you can directly use the square root formula. And the square root will be easily determined. Okay, so by this way, you can find out the area of the triangle. Okay, so you should remember the different formulas. For equilateral triangle, there are different formulas. For isosceles triangle, there will be different formulas. So you should remember each and every formula separately, so that you can apply the formula directly. Okay, in general, the area of the triangle is half base into height. In that case, base and height will be given. And in this case, in rule 2, if the sides are given, that means length of 3 sides are given, then how to find out the area of the triangle? So by using this formula, you can find out the area of the triangle very easily. And already I have given some problems in rule 1. So have you done it? If you have done it, so please give some comments. Okay, so today also I will upload this video, and at the end of this video, that means in the description, I will give you some questions with their answers. So please tell you your answer, whether all the questions you can solve or not, and how much time you are taking, whether you can do it very quickly or not. So please give anything, any comments in the comment box. Okay, so thank you, and tomorrow I'll give you the next video on equilateral triangle, and most important trick I will give you. Okay, so thank you so much.